Do you also want to get into the best engineering university in Canada? Well, the fact that you clicked into this video, I'm assuming you've probably already done a bunch of research about University of Waterloo and know how good the engineering program is. In this video, I'll fully break down the application process and also provide some tips so you can also get into the engineering program at the University of Waterloo. So I'll be talking about four components from most to least important, which are the admission average, AIF, video interview, and the adjustment factor. However, I say that some are less important, meaning you have less control over them. Doesn't mean you should just ignore them. So the first thing I'll be talking about is admission average. Your admission average is based on 6 grade 12 courses: advanced functions, calculus and vectors, chemistry, physics, and English, and also one elective of your choice. Most of the time, averages are calculated based on the marks available at the time for review, and you may include grade 11 courses if more recent marks are not available. For example, I did early acceptance, so I used my English 11 mark at the time since I didn't have my English 12 mark. For overall average, I would say try to aim for 95% above to be safe. If you look at this table from the Waterloo Engineering Admission Average website, it shows all the averages and probability of receiving the offer. Also, your chance of receiving offer also varies between different tiers. On this graph, if you can see, for an average of 95% in Tier 1, which are biomedical and software engineering, you will only have 10% chance of receiving the offer, around 42% in Tier 2, and 78% in Tier 3. So to summarize, obviously the higher your average, the better. Personally, I think admission average is the easiest portion since it is something you have greater control over. If not, you will have to rely on other parts, which is what comes next, the AIF. So what is AIF? AIF is the admission information form that consists of short answer questions and help Waterloo to learn more about you. It is a crucial part of the application process for engineering, not only for admission, but also for scholarship decisions. So this is the part where you brag about yourself, your work experience, accomplishments, and interests. What they are looking for really isn't any specific extracurricular activities or any accomplishment. Instead, they're looking for people who are able to demonstrate qualities such as initiative, leadership, time management, people skills, and variety of interest and involvement. So here are some tips for AIF from my personal experience. First, focus on how your experience relates to the program you're applying for. So for example, maybe you've attended hackathons and that developed your passion for programming, or maybe you're the president of the programming club. These are all really good experiences that are related to the program you're applying for. Second is to explain how your experience demonstrates the qualities they're looking for. Any qualities such as leadership, time management, or initiative, these are all really good traits Waterloo wants to see. For example, I was doing a part-time job at a tutoring center back in high school, so I can talk about how I demonstrated leadership from tutoring students, as well as how I can balance my time between job and school with great time management skill. And the third point is, don't put any irrelevant stuff. The space is limited for each question, so only talk about the things that are meaningful. Don't talk about things like you've wanted to become an engineer since you were 7 or your favorite food. They really don't care about that. Lastly, don't leave anywhere blank. If there is a section for additional information, put down anything. Just any experience so they can understand more about you. Also, if you're the winner of any Waterloo's math or science contests, it would be helpful if you can include them in your AIF. So the entire AIF is marked out of 5. According to the professor in Waterloo Engineering, normally students get around 2.5 to 3.5 out of 5. Students who got 5 out of 5 are usually students with provincial or national level awards winner, which is pretty rare. Next up is the video interview. So even though it says video interview is optional, however, I'm like 99.9% sure that everyone is going to do it. There are 3 questions to the interview, 2 requiring verbal responses, and 1 with written response. The goal of the interview is basically for Waterloo to have another way to get to know more about the students. It also gives students another opportunity to talk about their experiences and goals. Since Waterloo Engineering is co-op only, during co-op, you'll have to do a bunch of interviews, and this interview is kind of like a practice for you to start thinking about interview skills. A good way to practice interview is by doing mock interviews. You can ask your friends or family members to ask you questions and practice to get used to talking about things such as your career goals or why you chose the program you want to go into. My tips for this part is by answering using this structure. So first, explaining the context of the situation, and second, talk about what you accomplished and how you did it, then conclude with the results and lessons learned. There are a bunch of interview practice questions you're able to find online. I can link one down below in the description for you to take a look. Next up is the adjustment factor. So what is adjustment factor? Adjustment factor is basically the difference between first year engineering average and the admission average grouped by school or region. How does this work? For example, someone had an average of 91% with school X with adjustment factor of 10 versus another person had an average of 95% at school Y with adjustment factor of 16. The person at school X will result in a higher score. So the lower the adjustment factor, the better. And the average adjustment factor is around 16%. Personally, I don't really think it's that fair since students don't really have that much control over this factor. That's why I would highly recommend you to get as high as possible on the previous components like your admission average, AIF, and video interview. So this is what the scoring system looks like. If you had an average of 95, adjustment factor of 16, 3 out of 5 for AIF, and 2 out of 3 for video interview, you will result in a score of 84. To conclude, from my experience, I would say the strategy is to focus on your admission average, AIF, and video interview. Adjustment factor can impact your score, however, it isn't something you're able to control sometimes. For example, I just went to whichever high school closest to my house because that way I don't need to wake up too early for school. So that's it for this video. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe to my channel for more videos. I'll link all the resources down in the description. Also, feel free to ask questions down in the comments or DM me. After you got the offer, make sure you check out this video about everything you need to know about Waterloo Engineering. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.